Hello students, good afternoon. In the last class, we have discussed about problems based on skewness. Today, we will continue the remaining problems. Okay, here the sixth problem is calculate Wallace coefficient of skewness from the data given below. Calculate Wallace coefficient of skewness from the data given below. Okay, yesterday we have discussed Karl-Pearson coefficient of skewness. Okay, today we are going to discuss about Wallace coefficient of skewness. Here they are given class interval with respect to frequencies. Here class intervals are 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80, 80 to 90 and 90 to 100. With respect to frequencies are 1, 3, 11, 21, 43, 32 and 9. Here the Wallace coefficient of skewness formula is SV equal to SV equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2Q2 divided by Q3 minus Q1. Here the Wallace coefficient of skewness formula is SV equal to, that is, Q3 plus Q1 minus 2Q2 divided by Q3 minus Q1. Okay, where Q1 is the lower quartile, Q2 is the median, that is second quartile, and Q3 is upper quartile. Okay, here first we have to find Q1, Q2 and Q3, then substitute the formula. Okay, here first you have to find Q1, Q2 and Q3. Okay, here first you have to find n by, okay, here while calculating quartiles, the frequencies should be converted into LCF. While calculating quartiles, the frequencies should be converted into LCF. Here LCF 1, okay, frequency first term and LCF first term both are same. 1. 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 11 is 15, 15 plus 21 is 36, 36 plus 43 is 79, 79 plus 32 is 111, 111 plus 9 is 120. Here capital N equal to 120, capital N is 120. Okay, next step, you have to find N by 2. N by 4, next 2N by 4 and 3N by 4. Here N by 4 means, that is, first quartile, 2N by 4 is second quartile, that is median, and third, that is upper quartile, is 3N by 4. Here the first n by 4, that is capital N is what? 120 by 4. 120 by 4 is 30. The next 2n by 4, that is 2 1s are 2 2s are, that is n by 2. N by 2 equal to, that is 120 divided by 2, then you will get 60 is the answer. Okay, the next 3n by 4, 3n by 4 equal to 3 into 120 divided by 4. Okay, 3 into 120 divided by 4, 4 1 ja, 4 3 ja, that is 90, 30 3 ja, 90. Okay, next we have to find Q1 class, Q2 class and Q3 class. We want Q1, Q2 and Q3 class. Okay, here the first one is Q1 class. Class corresponding to class corresponding to 30th observation. Q1, that is 30th observation. The class corresponding to 30th observation. Okay, here Q1, that is 1 by 4, 30, and okay, here you have to take 30th observation is here here we have to refer LCF. 30th observation is 16 to 36 belongs to 60 to 70. It is the Q1 class. It is a Q1 class. Here 60 to 70. Okay, here the Q1 class is 60 to 70. The next Q2 class. Q2 class. Class corresponding to class. Corresponding to, say, Q2 class corresponding to 60th observation. Okay, here the class corresponding to 60th observation. Here you have to refer LCF. 37 to 79 belongs to 70 to 80. Our result is what? 60. It belongs to 70 to 80. It is a Q2 class. 70 to 80. And next Q3 class. Class corresponding to 3 class. Class corresponding to, that is 3n/4. That is 90th observation. Okay, these are, we have already discussed in the partition values. Okay, that is quartile, decile and percentile. Okay, here first we have to find Q1 first quartile. What is the formula? Q1 equal to L plus 1n/4. 1n/4 means it is 1, directly 1, minus CF by F into C. Here Q1 equal to what? L plus n by 4. Why 4 here? The distribution can be divided into 4 equal parts, quartiles. There are totally 3 quartiles are there. Okay, here first quartile, second quartile and third quartile. Okay, here n by 4 minus CF by F into C. Okay, here suppose find second quartile means here you have to take 2n/4, that is n/2, 2 1 2 2 2. Okay, the next find third quartile means 3n/4 minus CF/F into C. Then substitute the values. Here Q1 class is what? 60 to 70. Q1 class is this one, 60 to 70. Here the lower class limit, lower limit of the first quartile class is 60, frequency is 21, and cumulative frequency of the preceding class is 15, and width of the class interval is 10 each. Okay, here L is what? Lower limit of the first quartile class, that is 60 plus n/4. Okay, n/4 is what? n/4 is 30 minus CF. Cumulative frequency of the preceding class means above class. We have to take 15 divided by frequency of the first quartile class, that is 21 into 10. Here 60 plus, okay, 30 minus 15 is 15. 15 divided by 21 is 0.75. 0.75 into 10. Here 60 plus 0.75 into 10 is 7.5. That is 67.5 is the Q1 value. Q1 equal to what? 67.5. Okay. The next Q2. Here Q2 equal to L plus n/2, 2n/4, okay, n/2 minus CF divided by F into C. Here the second quartile class is what? 70 to 80 is the second quartile class. Here the lower limit of the second quartile class is 70 plus n/2 is 60 minus CF, cumulative frequency of the preceding class. CF is above class, that is 36. 36 divided by frequency of the frequency is 43 into 10. 70 plus 60 minus 36 divided by 43, 0.558 into 10, that is 5.58. Then we will get 75.58. Okay. The next, we have to find Q3. Okay. Sorry, okay, here Q3 class corresponding to 90th observation. We have not calculated. Okay, see. The class corresponding to the 90th observation, refer LCF. 90th observation means 80 to 111, belongs to 80 to 90. It is the Q3 class. That is 80 to 90. 80 to 90 is the quartile class. The next, Q3 equal to 3n by 4 minus CF by F into C. Into C. Then substitute the values, where L is the lower limit of the third quartile class. Lower limit of the third quartile class is 80. Plus 3n by 4 is 90, minus cumulative frequency of the preceding class is 79, divided by frequency of the third quarter class is 32 into 10. Here 80 plus 90 minus 79 is 11, 11 minus 32 is 0.34 into 10 is 3.43. Then we will get 83.43 is the answer. Q3 equal to 83.43 is the answer. The next, we have to apply formula, that is SP equal to Boyle's coefficient of skewness equal to SP equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2Q2 divided by Q3 minus Q1. Then substitute the values. Q3 value is what? 83.43 plus Q1 value is 67.5 minus 2 into Q2 value is 75.58 divided by Q3, that is 83.43 minus 67.5. See here, 83.43 plus 67.5 is 150.93 minus 2 into 75.58. 2 into 75.58 is 151.16 divided by 83.43 minus 67.5 is 15.93. The next, 150.93 minus 151.16 is minus 0.23 divided by 15.93. Therefore, SB equal to minus 0.23 divided by 15.93 is minus 0.014. It is the SP value, that is coefficient of skewness based on Boyle's coefficient of skewness. Okay, SP equal to minus 0.04. Okay, yes, got it. Here it is a 10 marks question, very important. It is a fixed question. Okay, calculate Boyle's coefficient of skewness based on moments, based on from the following data given below. Okay, here they are given class interval with respect to frequencies. While calculating quartile, the frequency should be converted into LCF. Okay, here we have to find Q1 value, Q2 and Q3 values. First, we have to find Q1 class, Q2 class and Q3 class. Then how to calculate Q1, Q2 and Q3 class? That is, we have to find N by 4, 2N by 4 and 3N by 4. Okay, it is the first quartile, second quartile and third quartile. Okay, here N by 4 is the first quartile, that is N is 120 by 4 is 30, 2N by 4 is 60 and 3N by 4 is 90. Here, the Q1 class is equal to class corresponding to the 30th observation, means first. N by 4 is what? 30. 30th observation is, we have to refer LCF, 30th observation lie in the 60 to 70, L is 60 and frequency is 21 and cumulative frequency is preceding class, that is 15. Then substitute the values, then you will get answer. Okay, it is the sixth problem. The next, seventh one is, here in seventh problem, calculate coefficient of skewness based on quartiles. Here, they are given class interval with respect to frequencies. Here class intervals are 10 to 19, 20 to 29, up to so on 80 to 89. Okay. Here they are given open end class interval. Here they are given inclusive class interval. They are given inclusive class interval. It should be converted into exclusive class interval. Okay. Here what is inclusive class interval? If the lower limit of the one class is, if the lower limit of the one class is not repeated as the upper limit of the another class. If the lower limit of the one class is not repeated as the upper limit of the another class, then it is said to be inclusive class interval. Then what is exclusive? If lower limit of the one class is repeated as the upper limit of the another class, then it is said to be exclusive. Okay. Then how to convert inclusive to exclusive class interval? Okay. Here in lower class limit, we have to subtract from minus 0.5 and upper class limit, we have to add 0.5. Okay. Here 10 to 19 is there. Here 10 to 19, we have to subtract from minus 0.5. 10 minus 0.5 is 9.5. And upper class limit, we have to add 0.5. That is 19.5. Here 20 minus 0.5 is 19.5. 29 plus 0.5 is 29.5. Here 19.5, 29.5. Same as it is, 29.5. 39.5, 39.5, 39.5, 59.5, 69.5, 69.5, 79.5, 79.5 to 89.5, 89.5. Here you have to subtract it from all the lower class limits. Okay, and okay, in 89.5, 10 to 19 and 19.1 more is there. Okay, here 99.5 to 49.5, 49.5 to 59.5, 59.5 to 59.5, 59.5 to 69.5, 69.5 to 79.5, 79.5 to 79.5, 79.5 to 80.5. Here you have to subtract from lower class limit, that is 0.5, and add to the upper class limit, that is 0.5. Here 9.5 to 19.5, up to so on 79.5 to 89.5. Okay, here it should be converted into L, frequency should be converted into LCF. The next we have to find Q1 class, Q2 class and Q3 class. Find N by 4, 2N by 4 and 3N by 4. Q1 class equal to class corresponding to the dash of the observation, up to so on. Okay, and then substitute the values in the formula, that is SP equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2 Q2 divided by Q3 minus Q1. Okay, it is a homework. Okay, the next problem, 10th problem. For a moderately skew distribution, arithmetic mean is, 10th one, arithmetic mean is x bar is 160, mode is 157, that is z is 157, and standard deviation sigma equal to 50. Find coefficient of skewness. Find coefficient of skewness. Here you have to find SK. Okay, here you have to apply formula, that is SK equal to x bar minus z by sigma. Here x bar value is what? X bar value is 160, 160 minus z value is 157, divided by sigma value is 50. 160 minus 57 is 3. 3 divided by 50. Okay, here 3 divided by 50 is 0.06. It is a coefficient of skewness, 0.06. Okay, the next 11th problem. In a frequency distribution, the coefficient of skewness based on quartiles is 0.6. Here they are given the coefficient of skewness based on quartile is 0.6. Means here they are given directly SB value is 0.6. Okay, the next, if sum of the upper and lower quartiles is Q3 100, if sum of the upper and lower quartile, that is Q3 plus Q1 equal to 100, and the median is 38, median means that is Q2 is 38, find the value of the upper quartile. Here we have to find Q1 values. Find Q1 values. Okay, here they are given coefficient of skewness based on Boyle coefficient of skewness is 0.6, and upper and lower quartile, the sum of the upper and lower quartile is 100, and median, that is Q2 is 38, find upper quartile. Okay, here we have to apply SB formula, that is quartile, that is SB equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2Q2 divided by Q3 minus Q1. Okay, here Q3 plus Q1 is 100. Okay, Q3 plus Q1 is 100, then Q1 equal to 100 minus Q3. Here then Q1 is what? Q1 equal to 100 minus Q3. Okay, then substitute the values, SB equal to 0.6. Q3 plus Q1, sum of the upper and lower quartile is 100 minus Q2 into Q2. Q2 value is what? 38. 38 into 2 is 76 divided by Q3 minus Q1. Q1 value is what? 100 minus Q3. 100 minus Q3. The next 0.6, 100 minus 76 is 24 divided by Q3 minus 100. Okay, minus 1 minus plus, that is plus Q3. 0.6 equal to 24 divided by Q3 plus Q3 is 2Q3. 2Q3 minus, minus 100. Okay, then you have to cross multiply. 2 into 0.6 is 1.2, that is 1.23 Q3, 0.6 into 100, 60 equal to 24. Okay, here 1.2 Q3 equal to 24 plus 60, 1.2 Q3 equal to 84, Q3 equal to 84 divided by 1.2, then we will get 70. Therefore, Q1 equal to what? 70. Therefore, Q1 value is what? 70. Here, we have to substitute the values. Q1 is 70. Okay, the next problem. Yes, got it? Okay, the next one. 12th problem. Given, Boyle's coefficient of skewness is minus 0.8, SP equal to minus 0.8, Q1 is 40, and Q3 is 60, find Q2 value. Okay, apply formula, that is SP equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2Q2 divided by Q3 minus Q1. Then if you have to substitute the values, SP equal to what? Minus 0.8 equal to Q3 plus Q1, that is 60 plus 40 divided minus 2Q2, Q3 minus Q1, 60 minus 40, minus 0.8, 60 plus 40 is 100, 100 minus 2Q2 divided by 20. Multiply, okay, here you have to multiply, cross multiply, minus 0.8 to 20, the next 100 minus, the next, see here, minus 0.82 into 20 is minus 16. Minus 16 equal to 100 minus 2 q2. Okay, here minus 100 minus 100 minus 16 minus 100 is minus 116 equal to minus 2 q2. Q2 equal to minus 116 divided by minus 2, minus minus cancel, that is 116 divided by 2 is 58. Q2 equal to 58. Okay, it is a 2 marks question. Okay, it's complete your skewness part. Okay, next, we shall continue the, we shall start kurtosis. The next one is measures of kurtosis. Kurtosis. Okay. Here, that is the fourth analysis of univariate data. The first one is measures of central tendency, second one is measures of dispersion, third one is measures of skewness, and last fourth one is measures of kurtosis. Okay, here what is a kurtosis? Skewness means that is asymmetrical distribution is said to be skewness, or lack of symmetrical distribution. Lack of symmetrical distribution is said to be skewness. Then what is the kurtosis? Here the kurtosis means the peakedness of the frequency curve. The peakedness of the peakedness of the frequency curve. Frequency curve is called kurtosis. See here, the peakedness of the frequency curve is called kurtosis. Peakedness means that is mountain height, that is the highest point. See, it is said to be peakedness. Okay, here the peakedness of the frequency curve, it is the frequency curve, normal curve, is said to be kurtosis. Okay, here peakedness means that is height, mountain height, that is the highest point, is said to be peakedness. Okay, here the peakedness of the frequency curve is called kurtosis. Okay, here there are totally three types of kurtosis are there. There are three types of kurtosis. Types of kurtosis. There are three types. One is mesocortic distribution. Mesocortic distribution. Second one, leptocortic. Cortic distribution. And third one is platycortic. Okay, here there are totally three types of kurtosis are there. One is mesocortic, second one is leptocortic, and third one is platycortic distribution. What is a mesocortic distribution? What is a mesocortic distribution? A distribution. A distribution which has peaked as normal distribution is called mesocortic distribution. See here, और डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन व्हिच इज हैज पीक्ड एज अ नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ओके हियर अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन व्हिच इज हैज पीक्ड एज अ नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज कॉल्ड मेजर क्वाड्रेटिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ओके सी हियर see it is a frequency curve, here range is minus infinity to infinity, the origin is zero. It is a frequency curve, that is a normal curve, normal distribution curve. It is said to be normal distribution curve. It is a bell shaped curve. It is a bell shaped curve. Okay, here what is a major quadratic distribution? A distribution which is has peaked has a normal distribution is called a major quadratic distribution. Okay, suppose if that curve is if the curve is of type normal distribution, then it is said to be mesocortic. A distribution which is has peaked has a normal distribution, then it is said to be mesocortic distribution. It is a mesocortic distribution. Mesocortic distribution. That is okay. Here, the skewness is denoted by beta 1, and kurtosis is denoted by beta 2. That is beta 2 equal to 3. Beta 2 equal to 3. Mesocortic distribution is 3, always 3. Why you are taking 3? Because there are totally 3 cortices are there, kurtosis, meso, lepto and plati. Therefore, you have to take beta 2 equal to 3. Beta 2 indicates kurtosis. Okay, that is 3 indicates that is mesocortic. Okay, here beta 2 equal to 3. Okay, it is a distribution which is has peaked as a normal distribution is called a mesocortic distribution. Okay, the next one is what is a leptocortic distribution? A distribution which is more peaked. A distribution which is more peaked than the normal distribution. Is called leptocortic. A distribution which is more peaked than the normal distribution. Then it is said to be leptocortic distribution. See, here it is a normal curve. Okay, a distribution which is more peaked than the normal distribution. Okay, normal distribution is average. Okay, here more peaked than the normal distribution. See, it is a leptocortic. Leptocortic, that is beta 2 is greater than 3. Here more means we have to take greater than symbol. Okay, here a distribution which is more peaked than the normal distribution, then it is said to be leptocortic distribution. Then what is a platycortic? Reverse, a distribution which is less peaked than the normal distribution or normal curve. Is called platycortic distribution. See, here a distribution which is less peaked than the normal distribution compared to mesocortic, it is less. See, here a distribution which is less peaked than the normal distribution is said to be platycortic. It is a platycortic. Symbol is what? It is denoted by beta 2 is less than 3. Beta 2 is less than 3. Here, yes, got it? Here, what is a kurtosis? The peakedness of the frequency curve is called kurtosis. There are totally 3 types of kurtosis are there. One is mesocortic, leptocortic, and platycortic. Okay, then what is the mesocortic distribution? a distribution which is peaked as the normal distribution is a mesocultic. A distribution which is more peaked than the normal distribution is leptocultic. A distribution which is less peaked than the normal distribution is platycultic. Here the kurtosis is denoted by beta 2. Measures of kurtosis is denoted by beta 2. Here beta 2 indicates kurtosis. Here 3 indicates that is kurtosis, that is greater than, that is equal to is mesocultic, greater than is leptocultic, and less than is platycultic distribution. Okay, the next one, the measures of kurtosis based on movements. Measures of kurtosis based on movements. Measures of kurtosis based on movements. Okay, measures of kurtosis based on movement. Okay, here the professor Carl Pearson, Pearson's given the that is beta 2 equal to mu 4 by mu 2 square, where mu 4 is fourth central movement. The next mu 2 is second central movement. Here measures of kurtosis based on movements. Here you are using Professor Carl Pearson given formula, that is beta 2 equal to mu 4 by mu 2 square. Okay, here beta 2 is a kurtosis. Okay, beta 2 equal to mu 4 by mu 2 square, where mu 4 is the fourth central moment and mu 2 is the second central moment. It is the formula, measures of skewness, sorry, kurtosis based on moment formula is beta 2 equal to mu 4 by mu 2 square. Okay, the next part is for mesocultic distribution. Beta 2 value is equal to 3. For mesocultic distribution, beta 2 is 3 and gamma 2 is also 0. Gamma 2 value is 0. The next, for leptocultic distribution, beta 2 value is greater than 3 and gamma 2 is greater than 0. The next, for platycultic distribution, beta 2 value is less than 3 and gamma 2 is less than 0. Why you are taking 3 instead of 1 or 2, 4? Because the total 3 quartiles are there, therefore you have to take 3 only, 3 number. Okay, that is equal to, indicates mesocultic, greater than is leptocultic and less than is platycultic, and gamma 2 value is 0 and gamma 2 value is greater than 0 is leptocultic. In the case of leptocultic, in the case of platycultic, gamma 2 value is less than 0. Okay, it is about kurtosis. Okay, the next problem based on kurtosis, here only one problem is there, that is 13th problem. The first four central moments are the first four central moments are the first four central moments and means mu 1 mu 2 mu 3 and mu 4. Okay, here the first four central moments are mu 1 equal to 0, mu 1 equal to 0, mu 2 equal to 40, mu 3 equal to 100 and mu 4 equal to 200. And mu 4 equal to 200. Here the first they are given, the first four central moments are here mu 1, mu 2, mu 3 and mu 4 are the four central moments, the first four central moments. Here mu 1 value is 0, mu 2 is 40, mu 3 is 100, mu 4 is and mu 4 is 200. Comment on the skewness and kurtosis. Comment on the skewness and kurtosis. Okay, here comment on the skewness and kurtosis means skewness, measures of skewness is denoted by what? Beta 1. Beta 1 equal to mu 3 square by mu 2 cube. See here, beta 1, measures of skewness is denoted by mu 3 square. Beta 1 equal to mu 3 square by mu 2 cube. Mu 3 square means that is 100 square divided by mu 2 value is 40. 40 cube. Then you will get 100 square is 10,000. 40 cube is 64,000. Then 10,000 divided by 64,000 is 0.156. 0.156. Comment on the skewness. Okay, here there are totally two types of skewness are there, positive and negative. Which one it is? Here answer is positive, na? Therefore it is positively skewed distribution. It is a positively skewed distribution. It is a positively skewed distribution. Okay, and the next, beta 2 equal to what? Beta 2 equal to mu 4. Beta 2 indicates what is the measures of kurtosis, that is mu 4 by mu 2 square. Okay, mu 4 value is what? 200. And mu 2 value is what? 40 square. Okay, here 200 divided by 40 square is 1600. 2 cancel, that is 2 8s, that is 1/8 is 0.125. Comment on the kurtosis. Okay, here beta 2 value is what? 0.125. beta 2 value is 0.125. suppose if beta 2 is exactly 3, then it is a mesocortic. Beta 2 is greater than 3, leptocortic, and beta 2 is less than 3, that is a platycortic. It is which distribution it is? Here beta 2 value is 0.125, means here beta 2 value is less than 3, means it is a leptocortic distribution. It is a platycortic. It is a platycortic. Platycortic distribution. Yes. Okay, yes, got it. Here we have to apply, comment on the skewness and kurtosis means here we have to apply, that is beta 1 and beta 2 values. Beta 1 is the measures of skewness and beta 2 is the measures of kurtosis. That is beta 1 equal to mu 3 square by mu 2 cube and beta 2 equal to mu 4 by mu 2 square. Okay, here comment means skewness means if suppose if positive means positively skewed, negative value means negatively skewed. Here in kurtosis, if greater than 3, then it is leptocortic, less than 3 platycortic, or exactly 3 means it is a mesocortic distribution. Okay, it is about kurtosis. Okay, it's complete your kurtosis part. Okay, here the analysis of univariate data completed. Okay, in the next class we shall discuss the new chapter, that is second chapter, organization of data. Okay, thank you.